Rainbow is one of the most beautiful things seen while it's raining. Welcome to Science Pedagogics, Science Made Easier. And our today's topic is Formation of Rainbow. Before proceeding, I would like to thank you all for your support and do like, share and subscribe this channel as your support matters a lot.
Namaskar children. Children, today we are going to discuss the most nature's most beautiful displays, that is rainbow formation. Actually, bachcho, this is not a real thing. We cannot touch rainbow, and rainbow does not exist in a particular place also. Then how it is formed and why it is formed? Because in science, if we want to understand any concept, then we should keep these two points in our mind, that how it happens and why it happens. Okay. The rainbow is observed, means we can observe rainbow only in that condition if there would be a presence of sunlight. Second thing, atmospheric conditions should be favorable in the formation of rainbow for the observation of the rainbow. And third thing is that the observer, when all these three things, means sunlight, atmospheric conditions and observer, all these are in right place, then the rainbow can be formed and we are able to observe that one. Means it is an optical phenomena. Actually, if we talk about science, then it is an optical phenomena which can be explained by the reflection of light as well as refraction of light also. Means to understand how rainbow is formed, we need to understand both the concepts of light, that is reflection and refraction of light. Okay, so let us try to understand that what happens in a water droplet, that it acts as a prism and it forms rainbow. Okay, rainbow we can observe just after the rain. Clear? For that one, there should not be cloud present in the atmosphere. There should be a presence of sunlight also. So let us try to understand the concept of rainbow formation. Children, what happens when sunlight, it shines on a droplet, means water droplet, which is present in the atmosphere. So that sunlight, when it enters, then again, here is a point of incidence, means it crosses the interface of air and water. Clear? So I'm just writing all the steps. Sunlight enters in water droplet. Okay, sunlight jo hai wo sabse pehle water droplet ke andar enter karti hai. To enter jab karti hai, us situation mein ek interface ko cross karegi, means it enters in water from air. Again, refraction, recall whatever we have learnt in previous videos, that refraction of light takes place. Is it clear? Rare medium to denser medium means bending of light towards normal, bending of light towards normal, and it splits out into 7 colors. When it enters in the water droplet, it splits out into 7 colors, and these colors are formed. Am I right? At the top, we have red color, and at the bottom, we have violet color. Clear? Now, the incident angle, because now these two rays, basically, I am talking about a band of rays. I am talking about the band of 7 colors. Not band of rays, sorry. I am talking about band of colors. So when this band of colors, they fall on the another surface, that is the interface between water and air. This is the surface which is interface between water and air. So the angle of incidence, the value of angle of incidence at this time is more than critical angle. Okay. So this is the first refraction. Second refraction, when it reaches at the second surface, it try to be come out from the water droplet. So here the movement from water to air, but at this time the angle of incidence, that is angle I, is greater than critical angle. That is the critical angle. Okay, so if angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, then refraction means the phenomena of refraction, it is ceased. It is ceased out. Means in place of refraction, this light ray again starts traveling in the same medium. This light ray, it starts traveling again in the same medium. So in place of refraction, it doesn't happen. It does not take place. In place of refraction, total internal reflection. Total internal reflection takes place. As you can see that the whole band of seven colors, they again reflected in the same medium. This shows the reflection in the same medium. So this is phenomena is known as total internal reflection of light. It happens at the second time. Clear? Why it happens? Because the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. Okay? Now, this reaches at the surface one more time. Now, this time means in the third case, the angle of incidence is less than critical angle. Okay? So, in that case, refraction takes place. Refraction of light takes place with dispersion. Means dispersion is happening inside the water droplet and refraction also takes place. Now these seven colors, they come out from this interface and these seven colors reaches inside the observer's eye and we are able to see rainbow formation. So this is the whole phenomena on which we are able to explain how rainbow is formed. First, that sunlight enters or shines the water droplets, then it enters from air to water medium, that is rare to denser refraction, bending of light rays towards the normal, scattering of light ray means there is a formation of seven colors spectrum inside the rainbow, inside the water droplet. But when these seven colors reaches at this interface, because the angle of incidence is less than critical angle, this is called as critical angle. So in place of refraction of light, total internal reflection take place. And due to total internal reflection, these seven colors, they will not come outside from the water droplet. They again start traveling inside the droplet and they reach at the another surface. At this time, the angle of incidence is less than critical angle. So children, here the one point that you can think, what is critical angle? So critical angle is the minimum value of incident angle for which the angle of refraction is 90 degree. Okay, means the value of incident angle for which the refractive means the angle of refraction, it becomes 90 degree, that is called as critical angle. And the symbol of critical angle is theta c. C stands for critical and this is for angle. It means during a rainbow formation, first what activities happens? That first one, refraction of light take place. Refraction of light takes place. Second thing, then followed by total internal reflection. Total internal reflection. Then again it is followed by refraction of light. And due to which we are able to see rainbow formation. But there is three conditions required for the rainbow formation. First, that sunlight, and second is atmospheric condition. And the third, that is very important, observer should be stand in opposite direction of sunlight. In the opposite direction. For example, sun is here. Okay, so rainbow can be observed here by this observer. By this observer means rainbow is always formed in the opposite direction of sun rays. Why? The reason is only that, for example, one of the person who is standing here, he can observe the rainbow. He can observe the rainbow formation, but he can't. Rainbow is formed after rain. Rainbow is formed after rain, but that observer is not able to view this one. The reason is only that because due to the presence of this sunlight, Due to the presence of high intensity of this sunlight, this observer cannot be able to observe the formation of rainbow. So, the three situations, presence of sunlight, atmospheric condition and the observer position, all these should be at right place if we want to observe the rainbow formation. Okay? So, I hope it is clear the concept behind rainbow and what are the essential conditions.
Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. And इस चैप्टर से रिलेटेड और वीडियोज़ आपकी स्क्रीन पे शोन है एंड प्लीज़ कीप अपडेटेड विद योरसेल्फ अबाउट आवर फर्दर वीडियोज़.